Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel, and in the video today we're looking at whether the UK really experiences massive power surges when soap operas finish and people start making tea. At first glance, the idea of the UK being simultaneously addicted to both trashy soaps and tea to such an extent that the country's national power grid experiences a massive surge of usage every time one ends seems like it must be a gross exaggeration stemming from a pair of stereotypes. As it turns out, though, this is not only a readily observable phenomenon in the UK, but it's such a normal part of daily life for the national grid operators that they have to keep track of what's going on in the plot of upcoming popular soaps and other shows to help predict ratings. They also keep TVs in their office in order to watch said shows so they can see precisely when a given episode ends. This is all necessary in order to keep the power grid fully operational during the very brief surges. This phenomenon, officially dubbed TV pickup by the engineers of the national grid, is largely thanks to a unique combination of the UK citizens' long-standing love affair with soap operas and the country's enjoyment of a good cup of tea and, more recently, instant coffee, and the almost universal adoption of electric kettles throughout the UK. Relatively power-intensive device using typically around 1,000 to 1,500 watts. The result is that for about 3 to 5 minutes after the end of a popular show, there's a rather large uptick in the demand for electricity across the country. As you probably guessed, this is roughly the amount of time it takes to boil a full kettle of water in such an electric kettle. The reason why these surges pose such a large problem is because, to quote an energy operations manager from the National Grid, Alan Smart, the way to think about it is to imagine you are in your car and your challenge is to keep the car at exactly 50 miles an hour. You press on the accelerator as you go up the hill and you ease off on the other side. We can't store electricity in any great quantity, so we have to forecast second by second, minute by minute. In a nutshell, the system as it stands today has limited capacity to ramp up electricity generation fast enough to deal with large, unpredicted surges, and it's quite expensive to dump off excess electricity from the grid if overproducing. For instance, even newer nuclear and coal plants can take hours to ramp up to full capacity and hours to ramp back down, with older plants being even less nimble, sometimes taking more than a day for such a large ramp up. Diesel and gas plants are much faster and much more expensive, but still need several minutes to a half an hour to ramp up. So how do engineers deal with the demand placed on the grid by as much as 1 to 2 million electric kettles being switched on at more or less the exact same time, and only for a few minutes? In short, as previously mentioned, the national grid first starts by pre-planning, keeping track of what major sporting events are coming up, as well as what's going on in various shows and general timetables of when said popular shows will probably end. This is an extremely tricky thing for sporting events, but it's also a difficult proposition for TV shows. While the BBC does give the national grid the times when the shows are scheduled to end, these are rarely perfectly accurate, and perfectly accurate is what the grid operators need in order to prevent brownouts or overproduction of power. With all this entertainment information, and using data from previous years, what they know about how weather affects power usage, as well as generation, with the UK projected to have 30,000 megawatts of wind power alone by the early 2020s, etc., their energy forecasters come up with the estimated power demand throughout a given day, including potential spikes and lulls. They then prioritize from where they'll be getting the needed power in order of expense, cheapest power sources first for a given area of the grid. However, even with all of this pre-planning, as previously mentioned, there is no simple way to ramp up the power fast enough for these TV pickups using the normal baseline sources, unless they just wanted to expensively dump the excess created before and after the spike to just accommodate the 3 to 5 minute surge. So how do they keep kettles on at a relatively reasonable price? Well, they maintain a series of power stations that are equipped with pumped storage reservoirs. These essentially hydroelectric batteries are capable of going from zero to peak production in under a minute. They do this by releasing massive amounts of water stored high up to power the generators below. For instance, the Norwich Power Station in Wales has one of the fastest response times of any pumped storage facility in the world. They're able to take the power output from nothing to maximum production, which is about 1800 megawatts, in roughly 16 seconds. If necessary, they can then sustain that for approximately 6 hours before the water runs out. At night, when usage is low and electricity is at its cheapest, remember, they can prioritize energy production based on cost so as demand demand dies, more expensive sources get turned off. The operators then have the water pumped back to the storage zone. For long-term generation, this is relatively expensive electricity compared to many baseline sources. On top of that, these reservoirs are largely supposed to be reserved for major outages, and thus only used when strictly necessary. However, these stations also provide the engineers a great way to keep the grid seamlessly operational during brief spikes, like TV pickups, where ramping up baseline sources just to service a few minutes would be a bit of overkill, or in the case of an unexpected spike, simply an impossibility. As for exact timing, engineers have small televisions tuned to the various TV channels, so they can note the exact moment popular shows end and use the seconds it will take viewers to walk to the kitchen to initiate production of the excess power that they expect they'll need. You can see this in action in the clip that we're showing right here. If you'd like to see more of that, it's from a BBC documentary. We will link to it in the description below. The documentary is called Britain from Above, and the engineer is reacting to the theme song of the soap EastEnders. This is to ensure the frequency of the grid remains as close to 50 Hz as possible. So now the question might be, just how big are the TV pickups? The largest TV-induced spike occurred in 1990, directly after the semi-final World Cup match between England and Germany, which was watched by an estimated 25 to 26 million people in the UK. For reference, at the time, the country's population was estimated to be about 57 million. The match ended in a penalty shootout, meaning that almost half the country was watching a live event to the end, with that end's timing being unpredictable. Needless to say, the national grid operators had their eyes glued to the match as well. When it did end in a German victory, an estimated 1.2 million Britons headed to the kitchen to drown their sorrows in a cup of tea, to the tune of almost an instant demand of an additional 2,800 megawatts of power from the national grid. For reference here, the normal total demand on the entire grid during peak times at that time of year is about 40,000 megawatts. And if you're curious, peak of peak on the grid in the year is roughly 60,000 megawatts. On the other end, in the night and the summer, usage typically drops to closer to 20 to 25,000 megawatts. Runners-up for the largest TV pickups include directly following a January 22, 1984 airing of The Thornbirds, 2,600 megawatts, the World Cup quarterfinal between England and Brazil in 2002, 2,570 megawatts, the end of the royal wedding of Prince William and Kate Middleton in 2011, 2,400 megawatts, and the end of an episode of the popular soap EastEnders revealing which character shot another in 2001, 2,290 megawatts. Thankfully, for the awesomely titled Energy Forecasters at the national grid, the rise of streaming services like Netflix and BBC iPlayer, among other on-demand services, as well as increased usage of time-shifting recording devices, has resulted in a noticeable drop in the size of these TV pickups. It's thought that the combination of more such media being made available to consumers in this way will eventually put an end to this somewhat unique British phenomenon. However, the national grid still reports that although popular shows no longer normally cause as large of a surge in demand as they once did, with reports from 2016 indicating that average spikes at the climax of shows today are about a third of what they were 15 years ago, the national grid still regularly sees spikes of 200 to 400 megawatts after popular shows. And if a given episode is particularly hyped for whatever reason, such as a season or series finale, the TV pickup will generally be closer to 700 to 800 megawatts. In either case, this is more than enough to cause power grid problems if they're not addressed immediately by the grid operators. National grid representatives also note that major sporting events and the like still have the power to pull the massive spikes of yore when they end, and citizens head to the kitchen for a good old cup of tea. And now for some bonus facts. Contrary to what you might think, the highest tea consumption per capita is not found in the United Kingdom, but rather Turkey, at 7.682 kilograms per person per year. The UK actually rings in at number 5, and it has actually been on the decline of late, with a 6% drop in tea sales in the last year alone in the UK, which has only continued the recent trend. On the flip side, coffee sales are rising in the UK at about the same rate as tea sales are falling. And now for another bonus fact. The TV pickups don't always go as planned. For instance, the National Grid once anticipated a massive surge in demand following an episode of the popular reality show The Great British Bake Off, directly after it was moved from BBC Two to BBC One in 2014. However, according to a representative from the National Grid, nobody in the entire country moved from the TV screen. There was no pickup at all. You see, at the end of the show, the first week when they expected the spike, the BBC scheduled a nature documentary just after it featuring baby pandas. From the lack of spike, it seemed that everyone stuck around to watch the pandas frolic in in the immediate aftermath and then slowly ceased watching over time, rather than one massive migration to the kitchen. Another big surprise was the November previous, during the airing of The Day of the Doctor, which had a massive audience, over 10 million people watching live in the UK. But as energy forecaster Jeremy Kaplan noted, the predicted TV pickup inexplicably didn't occur. And now for another bonus fact. TV shows aren't the only events that can cause weird power spikes. For instance, the largest spike of all time on the national grid occurred on August 11, 1999, directly following a solar eclipse, where a massive 3,000 megawatt spike was observed for a few minutes. A half hour before the eclipse, the total demand across the entire grid was about 35,500 megawatts. During the eclipse, usage dropped to about 33,000 megawatts. A few minutes after the eclipse ended, it was up to just over 36,000 megawatts. So I really hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already for brand new videos just like this every day of the week. Also, over there on the right, a couple of other videos that you might enjoy if you enjoyed this one, and thank you for watching.